A show coming to you from the Wolf Trap National Park for the Performing Arts out here in Virginia. Not too far from some of the major Civil War battlefields, Antietam, just north of here, where in just one day in 1862, 23,000 people were killed or wounded or missing. It was the bloodiest battle in American history, December 17th, 1862. It was the culmination of Lee's attempt to penetrate the North and get up into Maryland and bring the war to an early end. And after it, he retreated and he went back down into Virginia. Fredericksburg and Spotsylvania, not too far from here. Fredericksburg, also one of the deadliest battles in the history of the war. Lee, watching the battle unfold, said, "It is well that war is so terrible, or we would grow too fond of it." Gettysburg, just a little bit north of here, 80 miles up into Pennsylvania, turning point in the war, all of that there. And Manassas, Bull Run, as we in the North refer to it, which was the first big battle of the war. Union troops were poorly prepared, they were poorly trained, and they had the advantage, but when the Confederates counterattacked, they panicked and they ran, and it was a sobering day for both sides to realize just how long this war might go on. Arlington National Cemetery is not far from here, where John F. Kennedy is buried, and just down the hill is his brother Joe, who was killed in World War II in action nearby. Under a very plain marker is Ted Kennedy, and not far from him is Robert Kennedy, likewise under a modest white cross. Just down the drive is the grave of Admiral Richard Byrd, who was the great Arctic explorer, the first to fly over the North and the South Pole. And down the row is Gerald Thomas, a Marine Corps general, served in World Wars I and II and the Korean War, and lived to be 90 years old. A man named Richard Fleeson is nearby. He was a Navy veteran from Kansas. He commanded a destroyer during the Vietnam War. Nearby him is Justice Thurgood Marshall and Admiral Henry Wilson, the commander of naval forces in France in World War I. Victor Kolb, the first lieutenant, First Army, died in Vietnam in 1970, is nearby. And close by is a Frenchman named Philippe Lahermas, who fought with the Americans in Vietnam and died when his Huey helicopter crashed in 1969. It was once Robert E. Lee's farm, Arlington. He inherited it by marriage, and he abandoned it when he joined the Confederacy. And his very close friend, General Meigs, was deeply hurt by Lee's decision to go with the South, and he was assigned to find a burial ground for the Union dead, and he chose that place. It was on high ground, and it was very, very beautiful. It's enormous, Arlington, and if you walk a ways, you can see all the newest graves with the casualties from Afghanistan and Iraq, the men and women who were only in their 20s, and the words on their tombs: beloved son, love of my life, husband, father, best friend. Here's a song from Civil War days.
We're dancing tonight on the old campground. Give us a song to cheer our weary hearts, a song of home and friends we love so dear. Many are the hearts that are weary tonight, wishing for the war to cease. Tonight,
before the battle, Mother. I am thinking most of you while upon the field we're watching with the enemy in view. Comrades brave around me lying, filled with thoughts of home and God. For well they know that on the morrow some will sleep beneath the sod. Farewell, Mother, you may never me to your breast again, but oh, you'll not forget me, Mother, if I'm numbered with the slain.
He has sounded forth the trumpet that shall never call retreat. He is sifting out the hearts of men before a judgment seat. Oh, be swift, my soul, to answer him. Be jubilant, my feet. Our God is marching. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He is trampling out the vintage world.